What's up, guys? My name is Terry Everett. I am 23 years old, and I'll be starting BC. All right, let's restart. My name is Terry Everett. I'll be starting BCU School of Medicine class of 2025 this upcoming July. And basically, I'll be vlogging my whole process throughout medical school. And the reason I did this vlog is because I know it sounds cliche and corny, but it's for a lot of the students who don't necessarily think they deserve to go to medical school. They have imposter syndrome, or they have a hard time accepting the fact that they fully deserve to get into medical school and become physicians. So let's get started. We're going to do our thing. I was going to do an introductory video about who I am, what I do, etc. Y'all don't really care that much. I don't really care that much. So we're just going to jump right into it. The purpose of this video is to give 5 tips of what to do during your application process. A little bit about mine before we get started is that I worked 2 jobs. I took my MCAT and then went straight into the application process. So I was busting my
I'm sorry, sir. You can't say that.
I can't say that.
No, sir. Kids are watching.
What am I supposed to say?
A different word?
Why the f- am I supposed to do all this Like I'm playing, I wasn't cursing for a friend. But anyway, so application process, 5 tips. Let's get started. Number 1, throughout the entire process, be yourself. Everybody has a story. Don't try to push your story to the side. Embrace your story because that's going to be what is used to carry you throughout medical school and also throughout your application process before even starting. I had this thing where I felt like I don't know how to talk about myself. I hate talking about myself. So for a lot of medical pre-med students, it's really hard to communicate their successes because, you know, we don't really focus on it's always about like the next step, the next step, the next step. My tip would be look at your resume and don't transfer that directly into your personal statement. Extract the experiences that you've had, what you've learned, and also what you've been able to contribute through that, and just make a story out of it. Don't be textbook, don't be the rote button, you feel me? Just be yourself, it'll be fine. 2, I'll talk about my MCAT process in another video, but the application within itself is a marathon, not a sprint. Eventually, you're going to get so tired of writing that it's going to be like you don't even care. You just want to submit the application. You have the primaries, which is an extremely long application. Then the secondaries come right behind it. And the tertiaries, so you don't have tertiaries, but you have the secondaries, which basically tells you from each school about 4 to 5 prompts. Who are you and what do you contribute? And you look and you be like, dang, I just told you all of this stuff about me. Why can't y'all just take it from the application? But it's very important that you pace yourself because trying to rush everything into one application and trying to sell yourself 100% only in the primaries is going to drain you. So just relax, you know, and you got it. 3, have mentors. Mentorship and feedback is crucial during this process. When I was reading my original drafts, I thought, I was like, this is it, this is the one. And then I would get feedback from my mentors with like red ink, and I thought the pen had broken and the ink had bled on the paper, but it was actual feedback. I was like, dang, maybe I ain't got it like I thought I did, you feel me? But at the same time, they only want you to articulate most precisely and concisely who you are without having all of that extra fluff. Because for some of these responses, you get like 1350, I think, is the personal statement for the primary, but a lot of the secondary is like 750, and that seems like a lot of words, and it's like, it sounds like an arduous task to write that long essay. However, at the same time, that's not a lot to kind of contribute, to try to sell everything about you in 750 words for each prompt. So just make sure you're getting a lot of feedback because they've been through the process, they understand a lot better how to look through things and point out flaws that you have in your writing because they're seeing it from a different perspective. Tip number 4, have other activities. Like I said, I was working 2 jobs. I had to leave 1 job because the MCAT and the application was just too much to deal with. But you gotta make other time for your activities. That includes hobbies, going to the gym, reading, like just other stuff that gets you out of that bubble so it can be a catharsis and a breath of fresh air. So when you return, you're not looking at it as a daunting task. I definitely say I got overworked throughout the process and I was just like, I don't even want to do it. So I took 2 days to just not even look at my application process and everything. And that was really good because when I came back, I felt really refreshed and I was able to put my all into it. And also, you're going to need an very strong support system going through medical school. So you want to be able to allocate time towards your support system so you're giving to them and they're giving to you, not to be just transactional, but you also need to communicate what you need and then pour into them as they're pouring into you. Number five is kind of like number 3 with the mentors and feedback, but humble yourself. A lot of us walk into this challenge, you know, college wasn't as hard as it was for other people, and like I'm applying to medical school and all that stuff. Yeah, but now you're walking into 8 to 10 years of being unsure, or the rest of your life of being unsure. And you're always constantly learning. So seek feedback and be humble throughout your application, be humble throughout the process, because they're not trying to see who's the most smartest on paper. They're trying to see who can be compassionate, who has, you know, empathy, who is able to accept their mistakes, because in the long term, you're going to have people's lives at your hands. So you don't want to walk around like you know everything. If you don't know something or you have weaknesses, embrace those weaknesses and say, I'm learning about myself through my weaknesses, as opposed to just trying to sell your strengths. So the application process is very long. So definitely humble yourself, because when you get that feedback, you're gonna be like, dang. And I'll be like, what? And I'm like, dang, that's what I did. Bonus tip, do what works for you. And what I mean by that is, figure out what works best for you, whether it's your MCAT or the application process. I feel like I made the mistake of being overwhelmed by the concept of applying to medical school, that I was looking at a lot of YouTube videos and seeing what worked for other people and trying to apply that to myself. However, it just didn't work. So I wasted a lot of time. I learned a lot, but I wasted a lot of time trying to be somebody that I wasn't. And that's not what you need to be, especially during the process. So make sure you figure out what works for you and apply that to your application and seek different resources, but don't go through loopholes of trying to figure out and imitate other people. All right, guys, that's all for the first episode of many more to come. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, hit me up via Instagram at Terry_the_twin. That is at @TERY_the_twin. If you're a pre-med student, have any questions, if you're a medical student already or a physician who sees this and want to give back to me and other students, then feel free to reach out. I look forward to doing like partnerships, Zoom calls, Instagram lives, all of that, just to basically help all of us get through medical school. So you got this, guys. We got this. Loosen up and relax, because we got a lifetime of learning. So let's do it, baby. See you soon.